Good evening. Northern Territory Senator Nova Peris has used the launch of an anti-violence action plan to fire a scathing attack on the Northern Territory and federal governments. Senator Peris chastised both administrations for rolling back measures aimed at curtailing alcohol-fuelled and domestic violence as the figures for such assaults continue to skyrocket. Ryan Liddle has more.
Senator Nova Peris wasted no time in pushing the urgent need for change at the Canberra launch of the second action plan under the National Action Plan to Reduce Violence Against Women and Children.
As an Aboriginal woman in the Northern Territory is 80 times more likely to be hospitalised for assault than any other Australian. Not twice as likely, not 10 times as likely, but 80 times likely. Every night, the emergency departments of the hospitals and women's shelters are full of my sisters, battered and bloodied, victims of violence perpetrated by someone that they know.
The action plan is a national agreement between the federal, state and territory governments to reduce rates of violence over a 12-year period ending in 2022, with a special focus on domestic and family violence and sexual assault. Senator Peris took a swipe at both levels of government over the scrapping of the banned drinkers register and recent funding cuts.
Police, doctors, lawyers and judges all said that domestic violence rates would increase, and of course they did. The Northern Territory government is tolerating domestic and family violence. Aboriginal legal services provide a vital role right across Australia in reducing repeat offending across a range of offences, but in particular domestic violence. The Commonwealth Government has cut $13 million from Aboriginal legal services.
Criticisms aside, under the scheme, a new measure has been proposed to ensure the safety of families travelling interstate.
Currently in Australia, if a woman is subjected to violence and she receives a DVO in her home state or territory and she crosses a border, she has to re-prove that she was subjected to an act of violence again. That is not okay. We've awarded $3.3 million to CrimTrack. They are going to develop a prototype for us to pull together that national scheme.
A measure to protect women who flee their violent partners. But for Senator Peris, it's the epidemic of domestic violence at home that is the central problem that has to be addressed. Ryan Liddle, NITV News.